When they say I love you and cheat, as much as that sounds like a paradox to us, unfortunately for them, what that meant is...
Now, you're a psychologist
yes.
who really focuses on actually helping a lot of men.
Yes.
And where I want to start today, actually, is why is it that a man can say he loves you, he can actually seem really happy in that relationship, and then turn around and cheat on you?
Weirdly, in my experience, it is true. It's a dichotomy that I took me a really long time to understand, because for me, in order to love me, you have to respect me. And cheating involves an element of disrespect that, you know, I'm sure yourself as well, we don't really tolerate. But having worked with so many men over the years, what it is that they can love you but have unmet needs. And with men, because communication isn't their forte, they don't like to communicate what these unmet needs are. So they outsource them from another in another environment. So when they say I love you and cheat, as much as that sounds like a paradox to us, unfortunately for them, what that meant is I loved you. I didn't want to hurt you or upset you or tell you what was going on. So I just wanted to appease my own needs elsewhere at the expense of my relationship, which is not right. But it doesn't mean they didn't love their wife, which is really hard pill to swallow. But unfortunately, in their world, that's what it means.
So how that's actually really brilliant way of breaking it down. But then how, as women, when we're in a relationship, do we know that we can actually trust them? Because to your point, if you think that they're happy, if they're saying, oh my God, I love you, trust is a big freaking thing in that relationship. And so how do you start to communicate that? And how do you start to identify? Because I do think a guy has to take the responsibility as well, that if you're not happy, you need to speak up.
Absolutely.
But if they don't, how do you start to navigate that situation? How do you maybe even try to help prevent that situation? Yeah. And how do you not take it as a personal thing? Or is it personal?
It's definitely not personal. In my experience of working with them, it's definitely not personal. How you know if you can trust them or not, one of the good ways to understand is looking at their value system before they met you. Now, if they have a set of values where if they have unmet needs, the desire to feel desired or the desire to feel intimate with somebody exceeds their desire to remain in a monogamous relationship, then chances are at some stage they're going to risk the relationship. So you really have to look at their values as a person. Now, if they're the type of person that if they want something, they'll get it and they don't mind risking it all, then in the course of a relationship, they can stray. But if they're the type of person who, as much as they might want something, they recognize that the risk is not worth the cost, and they're quite risk averse in general, and they genuinely value their wife's well-being, that person will find it difficult. Even if his wife hasn't slept with him in a long time, hasn't made him feel special, if he cares about her well-being, he doesn't put his needs first. And so that guy is less likely to cheat. Now, as a woman, how you can navigate that is you sometimes some women, especially after children, they forget that the man still has needs. They forget that as tired as she is and exhausted as she is and so preoccupied, and this is no flaw of hers, it's just what happens when you become a mum, she naturally can forget that he needs a bit of attention, he needs a bit of love, he needs a bit of affection. And in her attempt to become a mother and a fantastic mother, she can often neglect her duties as a wife. So what happens is he doesn't want to say, oh, by the way, can you stop looking after the kids and come back to me? So he might outsource it. How I recommend you navigate that is just, and it's so difficult for women, but if you can make quality time to ask more open-ended questions to your partner, it makes a world of a difference. Rather than just, what time are you coming? Can you pick up the kids? Can you do this? It's like, how are you feeling? Is everything okay? What's stressing you out? You haven't been yourself. You stay attuned to your partner, they're less likely to stray. Doesn't mean they won't 100% and doesn't mean you're responsible, but they're less likely to stray. So it isn't personal, but what it is a reflection of is the communication has broken down in some way, shape or form. And it's finding a time to reconnect will prevent that from getting to an affair.
Okay. I love your honesty. I know what people are thinking at home right now. In the comments, they're saying, why is it my responsibility? The guy should own it. And actually, I actually want to be the voice of saying, you can't control them. No. You can't control if they're communicating, right? Like, people at home right now, please hear me. This isn't to blame women, but you can't control how the guy shows up. You can't force him to communicate. So I just say, in that situation, what is it that I can do and choose to do or not do, right? Yeah. I think that what you're doing right now And it's going to be very tricky to navigate, but I think it's super important. What you're doing is you're saying, this is the way the situation is. This is how men feel, whether you like it or not.
Yeah.
Now as women, at least if I have the choice to say, I'm going to ask my partner if there's any needs, or I'm exhausted, no, I'm not going to ask him. Cool, don't ask him. But just know the reality of what the potential outcome is going to be. So now setting kind of that stage. Yeah. You want to go back to something you just said about the value system.
Yeah.
So how do you start to identify that value system in them? Mm-hmm. I've heard you say that you can also ask some questions about their childhood that reveal how they are today.
Yeah.
So take me through what sort of things that we can ask our partners if we're dating or if we're starting or we're already in a relationship with someone to start identifying what those values are.
Okay. So great question, by the way. But what I would recommend is how you identify a man's values is you assess their kind of opinions on things that are not related to them. What I mean by this is one of the great things about our jobs is that we can kind of say, oh, someone said this today. What do you think about that? And so you might want to say something like, I read this article about men feeling neglected after a baby's born. What do you think about that? Or a colleague at work said that he feels like his wife doesn't want to have sex with him anymore. What do you feel about that? Or one common thing that a lot of people don't talk about is how men sometimes lose sexual desire for their wife after marriage, after living together. They might have been really rampant before, but they kind of lose their desire and they're not chasing their wife for sex the way they used to. And it's these kind of conversations, how you identify his values is his ability to be honest. Mm-hmm. Now, if you're with somebody who will tell you the truth, even if it hurts you, you're in luck. And as much as that might sound difficult, it actually creates emotional attunement. He's teaching you how to love him, and you do the same with him. But if you have a partner who is unable to express himself, what will happen is he'll find an outlet to express himself. Hopefully that will be a healthy outlet, but sometimes it can be an unhealthy outlet. So how you assess his value system is you assess how honest he is, even if he stick to the truth, even if it offends some people. And if he's the type of person where truth matters to him, then chances are he'll be more honest and you can create a connection that will prevent infidelity.
So I love the idea of asking someone the questions to see how they're going to respond. And then I've heard you say like that it's actually more likely that when a guy becomes a father, that they're more likely to cheat. Is that why? Because they start to, do they feel the guilt of putting it on the mother? And so they're just like, if I just go take my needs over here, now I don't have to make her feel bad that she's not giving it up.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, what happens is they recognize it is a selfish desire to expect her to be breastfeeding, looking after the baby, just push the baby out and then go and look after him.